Lord Stanley's Cup, as cherished as any piece of hardware in sport. And the tournament to claim it can produce electric moments.
Stops the shot!
The New Jersey Turnpike rivalry has produced its share of memorable plays as well. Three playoff meetings, each one special in some way. The intensity of the rivalry shining through and only growing with each game. They will meet for a fourth time this spring. Two teams familiar with one another and wary of the other's threat. The Flyers have something to build on, namely an impressive season series with the boys from North Jersey that included five Philadelphia wins in six games. Their mission is to carry that momentum over in the battle for the Stanley Cup. The playoffs are here. Game one, Flyers-Devils next. Get set for the postseason. Captain Mike Richards appears to be relaxed. Chris Pronger, getting the game face on. He'll see plenty of this guy, Ilya Kovalchuk, the sharpshooter for the Devils. And the Flyers must find a way to solve perhaps the best goaltender to ever play this game, Martin Brodeur. Matchups galore, should be great. Game one, Eastern Conference quarterfinals, Flyers and Devils here from Prudential Center in downtown Newark on Comcast Sportsnet. And a pleasant good evening. Welcome to Flyers Playoff Hockey along with Bill Clement. I'm Jim Jackson. Steve Coates will join us here in just a moment. Well, Bill, we're very happy to say we're glad to be along with you for the playoffs because it got a little hairy there for a while, but the Flyers are here now.
Never a doubt.
A little hairy.
Okay.
But they are very excited to be here.
Well, they should be. And game ones are obviously important if you're going to win a series, but I think it's even more important from a Flyers standpoint because they had their way with the Devils during the regular season, winning five of six games. So why is game one important? Well, if the Flyers can win, they can actually get that seed that they planted in the Devils' minds to start growing, and they can continue to believe that they're not only capable of beating the Devils, but they're going to have to score goals to do it, something they didn't have much trouble with during the regular season. If the Flyers want to do one thing better from the regular season, a little more disciplined.
Yeah, they did score a lot of goals. You notice there are 20 goals for the Flyers. It's always about goaltending come playoff time, and what a matchup here in this one, 10 years removed from a previous matchup.
Just seems like yesterday. No, it really doesn't, but it was a decade ago that Brian Boucher faced Martin Brodeur in a series, and Marty Brodeur talked about it in the last couple of days. He remembers how dynamic Brian Boucher was. And in the last 10 years, Boucher's had a lot of ups and downs in his career, but he's not only rebuilt the career, but he's built his game up and through the shootout win three nights ago against the New York Rangers. Marty Brodeur's resume is the best of any goaltender in the world right now, and he will retire as the greatest goalie in the history of the game, but it doesn't seem to scare the Flyers. The Flyers have been able to score on him. All Brian Boucher wants to do is to continue to build his game. He has done that in the last couple of weeks, all the way up to the shootout that he stopped in Oulu-Jokinen, and he actually made it look easy. Brian Boucher is a way different goalie today than he was even 3 weeks ago.
Yeah, no question about that. All right, so that's the goaltending matchup, but really, Bill, this is a series of many, many matchups, and you have a feeling that Kimmo Tiiminen and Chris Pronger will be part of those for the Flyers.
Yeah, without a doubt, and Peter Laviolette has retooled his defensive pairings a little bit. Chris Pronger will still have Matt Carl as his partner, but Kimmo Tiiminen is going to play with Lukas Krajicek, especially on the road. Peter Laviolette needs two sets of shutdown D to go up against two of the most dynamic forwards in the game. Zach Parise plays one forward position for the Devils on one line, and Ilya Kovalchuk plays on another line. And they will come at the Flyers differently. Zach Parise will do a lot of work down low, out of the corners. For a little guy, he's exceptionally strong and very hard to contain. Ilya Kovalchuk is all about power and speed. Oh yeah, Parise can supply some of that, but when you speed Kovalchuk at 230 pounds, he can beat you with his shot. It is laser-like. He can beat you with his speed. And believe me, when 230 pounds gets rolling through the neutral zone, it's really hard to stop. That is why Peter Laviolette needs two sets of D-men, one anchored by Pronger, the other one anchored by Tiimonen.
And so without question, the Devils do have weapons, but so do the Flyers. And Steve Coates, a couple of weapons that will have to be firing in this series. Jeff Carter and Mike Richards.
Boy, I tell you what, anybody you talk to in the game of hockey will always tell you your team is only as good as the guys you got up in the middle. And certainly Jeff Carter and Mike Richards, they fit that bill perfectly. Take a look at the games played and the numbers. They're number one and number two in scoring for the Philadelphia Flyers. Are the numbers for Carter this year not as good? He missed eight games because of a broken foot. Is he back to 100%? No. But he can still shoot the puck as good as anybody in the National Hockey League. He shot it 313 times. How do you score goals? Shoot the puck. And he's just going to get better and better as he gets into game shape. Now when you talk about Mike Richards, you talk about the guy that absolutely has about four different types of speeds. He can alter his speed. Great passer. Does great things on five-on-five, power play, everything else. Both these guys so important. So you don't want to miss this one. This building's going to be rocking. Coming up, it's the Philadelphia Flyers and the New Jersey Devils.
Tonight's Flyers-Devils game is brought to you by your local Tri-State Toyota dealers. Go Flyers, go Toyota. Toyota moving forward. By Budweiser, salutes America's designated drivers who ask, want to go home with me tonight? I'm the designated driver. Responsibility matters. And by Wachovia, the official financial services partner of the Philadelphia Flyers. Game one of this first round playoff series. 16 teams still in the hunt for the Stanley Cup. Two of them right here.
And our Kia Motors starting goaltenders, Brian Boucher, one of the heroes in the shootout three nights ago that sent the Flyers to the playoffs. Martin Brodeur, never a doubt about who's going to start any playoff game for the Devils.
And so this series is underway. Home red uniforms for the Devils, road whites for the Flyers. As the Devils get the puck out to center ice, plenty of Flyer fans in attendance. You can probably already hear some of them, but there's a lot of red as well. The Flyer, the Devils line combinations, or at least what we hope will be the Devils line combinations at the top of your screen, because with Jacques Lemaire, you never do know. Here's Jamie Langenbrenner moving up.
That's what, he's thrown a curveball at us already.
Not surprised.
Right.
Try to get those line combinations off of the pregame skate. Most coaches run them as they will during the game, but Jacques Lemaire has been known to try to throw those curveballs, and he's done so already here in this series.
The Devils players don't even know sometimes until after the warm-up what the real line combos will be.
Bryce Salvador for New Jersey, chopping that one back through center, hopped over Lucas Krajicek's stick, and now Zach Parise there for the shot. Save Boucher, the rebound back around behind the net. Devils after big hit on Clarkson as Ian LaPerriere ran him over. And the puck scoots out to center. Daryl Powell is there. And he'll tip into the Devils zone. Blair Betts is after it. Ian Travis Zajac. Zajac won the race. Betts, though, staying with him. Gives him a heavy hit into the corner boards. LaPerriere after it. Gets the puck to Betts. Betts then thumped along the wall, but still after that puck. Powell gets it back along for LaPerriere. And now it's Powell again. Daryl Powell has a look, back to the point. Oscars Bartulis, a shot redirected and the save made by Brodeur. Bartulis in the lineup for the Flyers as Ryan Parent takes a seat for now. And the puck ahead here to Patrick Eliashi. Tips it past Bartulis, gets to it, his shot off of Boucher and wide behind the net. Boucher got enough of it to keep it out of the cage. Now behind the net, Eliashi and Boucher come together.
Briere firing that one across ice. That's a turnover, but good job by Coburn to jab it away from Kovalchuk. Now back in it goes. Here's Big Dinah Subra centering, and it dribbles just wide. Kovalchuk could not get his stick on it. And yes, you can tell the pace is ramped up just a bit from the regular season. What a pace to start this game.
The tattooed parlors are open on both sides. Man, there's some hitting.
Here's James Van Riemsdyk, getting his first taste of Stanley Cup playoff action. Dumps it in and retrieves himself, but he's checked to the corner. The Martin School of the veteran defenseman got the puck to Kovalchuk, who's been out on the ice for a while on this shift. He clears the zone. Kyle quickly back to Van Riemsdyk, drops it off for Asham. The former Devil winds and fires. That's blocked off by Mike Motto, the defenseman. And Colin White will chip it to the boards. Dean McCammon to the line, and then they chip it past Matt Kyle before it's dumped back in. Two shots for the Devils early on, one for the Flyers as we approach the three-minute mark. A steal by Claude Giroux. He'll fire one off the stick of Brodeur wide of the net. Back to the point it goes. Krejcik backhand, that's blocked. He did not keep it in. Doesn't matter. Devils have it anyhow. Rod Pelly moving it ahead. Pierre-Luc Lalonde, who's in the lineup for the Devils. His shot off the stick of Krejcik and out of play. And a whistle.
Catch our breath. Give us a chance to look at our Land Rover keys to the game. Number one. The Flyers have to control Kovalchuk's speed. They will do that by controlling the neutral zone between the blue lines. A lot of traffic for Marty Brodeur. He can't stop what he can't seize and be battle ready. That's what Peter Laviolette talked to us about before the game. First 5 minutes, very important. He wanted to gauge the Flyers' level of readiness after being on such a high Sunday against the New York Rangers.
And so far, you'd have to say they're ready. Both teams really going full bore. Laviolette, the last time he was coaching a Stanley Cup playoff game, it was a Stanley Cup clincher for the Carolina Hurricanes. Both of these coaches have a Stanley Cup on their resume as coaches. Ryan Boucher gets that one away from Zajac to the other side of the ice. LaPerriere got it ahead, not out of the zone though. Zajac back after it. Pronger gets to him. Now LaPerriere just trying to clear the zone. It ricochets off of some skates. LaPerriere has it again in tight quarters and surrounded by red jerseys. Finally, though, the puck bounces all the way across ice and out to center. After it there is Andy Green, a defenseman who played so well for this Devils team early in the season when Paul Martin was out injured. Matt Powell back to pick it up. What a game he had for the Flyers on Sunday. Logging a ton of ice time and scoring the tying goal. Simone Gagné up, winds it, fires, glove, save, Brodeur, he had to stretch out to get to that one, and now Carcillo begins to push and shove with White, but they're separated quickly. We show you who's not playing in this game, our Virtua scratches. Talked about Ryan Parent out for Philadelphia. Milano also a coach's decision. Jay Pandolfo, one of the veterans out of the lineup for the Devils, who are relatively healthy.
That last game you mentioned that Peter Laviolette coached just happened to be a game seven of the Stanley Cup final. He's glad to be back.
Nemo teaming in, rolling this one behind. Carcillo gets it to the angle, on in front. Pass for Richards, never got there. Deflected away as Simone Gagné had the captain in his sights, but the Devils took care of the pass. Teaming in around for Krejcik. Tried to headman to Richards, but it was off the mark. Clarkson back the other way. Richards' former teammate. Kitchener of the OHL, they won a Memorial Cup together and they remain good friends. On White looking for Clarkson, missed him. Bounces all the way in on Boucher from the boards. 4.5 minutes in, still no score. First goal is important. Devils a very difficult team to come from behind against. The Flyers haven't been a great team when giving up that first goal this year, so you know they're wanting to light that lamp first, but here come the Devils. Dinah Subras moving in. Subras is shot blocked off by Bartulis. Flyers will get to it. Coburn moving it along for Danny Briere. Whip that one across ice. Bartulis does everything he can just to get it out of the zone. He took a high hit from Kovalchuk. Now Briere with a shot that's blocked by Skula out to center. Bartulis has to rotate back to get to it. Now Briere finesses that ahead to Hartnell. He's bodied by Skula. And Eliash is there to pick up the puck, looking to spring Kovalchuk, but right on him was Carl, who actually steals the puck. Carl now moving in, knocked down, still one hands it to Hartnell. Hartnell's pass knocked down by Kovalchuk.
He's trying to get to it, but Carl gets back to keep him away. What a great shift by Matt Carl.
Unbelievable. He stepped up to take away any kind of space that Kovalchuk had getting out of his zone. And then once Carl got knocked down, he still made it back to get him again.
The shot there, not a lot on it, as Brodeur will jab it away. And now Zach Parise ahead to Clarkson. He pushes the puck in and looks to go after it. Pronger thought about interfering with him, let him go, so no penalty. Steve Walkham, Wes McCauley, your referees for game one. Asham getting to the Devil's line, but he stopped right there, and Parise takes over. He'll chip it back to Brodeur. It goes past him, and Green will play it across ice. Now Martin bumped by Betts. Blair Betts with his steal. Finds Richards. Richards around behind the Devil's net. Harassed. Still got it to the side of the cage. Brodeur tried to pin it to the side of the net. He does, and we get a whistle stopping play. Great pace early on. No score. Tonight's first period on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you by Pepsi Max. Maximum taste, maximum energy, zero calories. And by VWLocal.com. Go to VWLocal.com or your area Volkswagen dealer to learn more about great deals on all their new vehicles.
Boy, what a start here tonight. And we always worry about that first 10 minutes where you got to kind of rope and don't figure the Devils are going to come at the Flyers. No. Right now, the Flyers are out shooting the Devils 3-2. So what Peter Laviolette wanted has happened. They've matched the intensity of the Devils early in this hockey game.
And it is really something to behold, the intensity of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Every puck is fought for. And there's one of those battles right here, and it's Mike Richards who steps away with the puck. This is Carcillo with the outlet. Carcillo and White come together again. Richards gets to the puck. And it's cut off by Ralston at the red line and dumped right back in. Richards has it there, and they'll drop it back to Lukas Krajicek, who has some playoff experience from his days in Vancouver. Turnover here, though, and here's Jamie Langenbrenner in. Drop pass, Ralston, the shot blocked off by Krajicek. He'll hand off to Richards, who darts to center. Richards in across the line, Chris crossing with Gagne, but losing the puck. And once he regains it, he'll send it around behind Gagne. Keeping it away from Green, centering shot, and the save made by Brodeur off of Asham. And the other way goes McCammon. Dean McCammon swinging wide, and his shot off. Boucher back behind the net, ricochets around there. Played back out to Green with some room. His wrist shot, deflected, dribbled just wide. Then Pelly tried to flip it in front, but it never made it out in front of the net. Oh, close calls at both ends as the Flyers clear the zone.
Is that funny? I'm not even sure it was ever headed right at the cage, but it dribbled by dangerously. I think changed speeds a couple of times heading towards Boucher.
Really did. Eliash firing that across. Devils making player changes. And now Kovalchuk tips to Eliash. Patrick Eliash trying to surge in. Coburn says, think about it again, but Zubras keeps the puck in the zone. Zubras wrapped up by Carl, had to let him go. Didn't want to get that penalty. And now it's Zubras centering. Tip with controlled shot. Kovalchuk. Whoa! Save Boucher! Oh, he flashes some leather there. Boucher introduces himself to the series in a big way.
What a way to get established. Unbelievable save. Ilya Kovalchuk is shaking his head here, and this is not the best place to give Kovalchuk the puck if you're trying to defend him. Just outside the hash marks, dead center, Aaron Asham had it tip off his stick right to him.
See where his glove is? That's the key. Watch where his glove is when Kovalchuk takes that shot. It's up. He doesn't have to flash it because it's already in a position to be able to make the easy glove save. Not real easy, but in the right spot.
Yeah, good point, Coatsy. You don't want to have to get there with your strength and your reflexes if you can be there waiting for the Kovalchuk shot.
And it was there. Ryan Boucher knows a thing or two about spectacular saves against this Devils team. I'm sure at some point, we already saw it once briefly in the open, but we'll probably see it again, his save on Patrick Eliash back in 2000. Still, one of the best saves I've ever seen. As Scott Hartnell moves in to the backhand, tried to center penalty. Hartnell taken down. Flyers will get the game's first power play as Bryce Salvador will go to the box.
What a determined play, though, by Scott Hartnell. He had speed, and he decided to go between the blade of Salvador's stick and his body.
Right there, you see Scotty Hartnell's going to just kind of push the puck, and then he wants to chase it. What he's going to use his body to be able to protect himself to get around Salvador. But when he did push the puck ahead, Salvador, a little bit of a miscue, because what he did, he's got the stick right into the skates of Hartnell. Down he went, first power play of tonight's game.
And so the special teams battle begins in this series. Regular season numbers. Flyers third best power play. The Devils in the middle of the pack with a penalty kill, but they were hot at the end of the year with the Devils on the penalty kill. Flyers 4-for-17 against New Jersey with the man advantage. They had not half as many power play chances during the season series as did the Devils. Richards pass here is tipped. Siemenin cannot keep it in the zone. Siemenin and Pronger manning the points to start the man advantage. Giroux, Richards, and Gagne were up front. They're going to take a seat. And a new line will jump on the ice, the Carter line, as Siemenin makes his way up and from the red line winds it in. Skula and Hartnell after it. Around behind it goes. Green ridden by Briere, but not that puck ahead, and Zajac is able to clear.
Still no chance for the Flyers to set this thing up. You know the Devils are going to be really tough on pucks, so the Flyers have to be ready for their retrieval game. Once the pucks get loose in the offensive zone, you've got to get it back and set it up.
They dump it in diagonally this time, but Green's the first to it. Plenty of room to bounce it all the way down.
The Devils right now are doing a great job. Every time that pucks come in, the Flyers have outnumbered the Devils in the zone. But boy, the defense for the Devils have done a great job of getting that puck and just wheeling and getting it out.
This time the Flyers do retrieve it, but Richards tried to pass down low to an off a skate. And Brian Ralston has killed a penalty or two in his career. Banks it all the way down.
Got back on the PK here in New Jersey and was saying this morning that he's really happy. I mean, a lot of guys draw energy from killing penalties.
He leads all active players. 33 shorthanded goals in the regular season. Now to just 8 seconds on this particular power play. Heavy hit along the boards. Richards on Green, but Green stays with it and got the puck to Skula, who will bank it ahead. Teeminen will get a penalty. Nimmo Teeminen got his stick in the midsection, and now the Devils will go to the man advantage. 9:32 to play here in the first. Ryan Boucher, Patrick Elias. What do you think we're going to flashback to here? 10 years ago, Eastern Conference Finals. Patrick Elias blows past Keith Jones. Ryan Boucher with a remarkable save. The mask coming off added to it. But that is one of the best saves you're ever going to see. It was in a tight hockey game. And Brian Boucher already has flashed some leather in this one with a nice save on Kovalchuk.
But Jonesy did a great job of getting the rebound.
He took care of the rebound. No question about that. Power play for the Devils. Kimmo Tiivinen off for hooking. As the puck comes across to Paul Martin for a shot. They look for redirection, but it went on through. Kovalchuk back toward the point, but that was tipped by LaPerriere. And so it bounced out to center. Regular season numbers for these units. 11. As Blair Vetch will send it all the way down. The Devils certainly got a lot of practice in the power play against the Flyers. 32 times, but they only scored 5 times. And the Flyers penalty killing was outstanding down the stretch of the season, going off 25 of the last 26 man down situations. As Richards moving up, and he'll play it into the Devils zone. Martin is back. Missed much of the season with a broken arm.
Missed the Olympics too.
Indeed. The puck bouncing away and now controlled by Zajac out to Martin. Across for Kovalchuk, who mans one of the points. Has that big heavy shot. Parise's pass intercepted, and LaPerriere again clears the zone.
Let's bring up Paul Martin. He could be the X factor because he was out so long. That certainly hurt the Devils because he's their quarterback back there. Oh yeah, Green did a great job in the meantime, but Paul Martin being back, him even being part of the Olympic team, if he had it gone, that just shows you how good he is.
Matt Carl, another nice play as he steals the puck and clears.
You talk about picking up where you leave off. Matt Carl was so good against the New York Rangers in game 82 of the regular season, and he's just as good here.
Keeps playing like that, he'll end up with the same kind of minutes he got in that game. I asked him after the game, did you sleep well that night? He goes, you better believe I did. There's Kovalchuk, a shot blocked by Carl, couldn't find it in his skates. Parisen and fans on his shot, though. Boucher still had to make the save, and then the rebound cleared out of harm's way. Back out to Kovalchuk. looking for a shooting lane. Instead, deals to Green. Green, a pass through the middle, missed everybody, out the other way and out of the box, jumps Timonen. And he's just going to clear it through the neutral zone as the Flyers will get a fresh line on the ice.
Really good job by the Flyers. They know the Devils often will not shoot a puck, but they'll put it into a spot for a redirection or a deflection. So you got to tie up people's sticks and make sure you watch people that are around the cage. So far, so good in that department.
And the Devils move the puck ahead here, but Zubras has stopped. The puck bounces into the Devils bench. And so a whistle with 7:01 to play here at the beautiful building in its third year for the Devils, the Prudential Center, downtown Newark. Along with our great crew here on Comcast Sportsnet in high definition, bringing you game one of this Eastern Conference quarterfinals. Jacques Lemaire back behind the bench for the Devils in the playoffs.
112 playoff games, coach number one for active coaches in the league.
Basham will spin that one around behind the net to Van Riemsdyk. His pass didn't get as much on it as he wanted to. Bartulis took out his frustration on Rod Pelly as the puck drifted out to center and down the ice. Van Riemsdyk unable to reach that puck. Now it's Pelly turning with it. Now State product. And Van Riemsdyk stayed with him and poked it ahead to Giroux, spun to the ice. And Bartulis will have to go back and get it. Oscar's Bartulis scratched a lot late in the season, but finds himself in the lineup here in the playoffs. And off the stick deep into the Devil's zone. Andy Green is there. Backhanding it ahead, but it goes through the team in it. Ideally, the Flyers want to get that puck into that Devil's zone and work the Devil's defense. I feel as though it's a defense that you can exploit some if you get them with their backs turned. Markson trying to center. That's blocked by Timonen, but picked up by Zajac. Out to Skula. Shot redirected wide. Parise got his stick out it, but missed the target. Hartnell's pass tipped away as Parise got back to play defense. Now Skula looking for Parise, and he's got it. A step on Krajicek. Cutting in the shot. Save Boucher. Puck goes behind the net. Parise centers, but it goes out to Danny Briere. He'll start the Flyers back the other way. Briere to the Devil's line. Holding on. Still holds. His shot deflected and goes into the safety net. 5.5 minutes remaining in period number one. 5 shots for the Devils, 3 for the Flyers. None have gone in. Ryan Boucher's been solid early on. Denies Parise there.
With playoff fever in the air, now's the perfect time to place your deposit for Flyers 2010-11 full or partial ticket packages. Discounts from box office pricing, flexible payment plans, access to exclusive team events. Packages start as low as $23 a game. Call 215-218-PUCK or visit PhiladelphiaFlyers.com.
Face off upcoming to the left of Martin Brodeur, and Alan White able to get to that. It's a strange caramount to Mike Motto. Ahead for Jamie Langenbrenner, the captain of the Devils. Set it off of Ralston's stick into the Philadelphia zone. Pronger pins Ralston, the puck behind the net. Matt Carl jamming it free for Richards, who didn't get past right where he wanted it to. And the Devils do keep it in the zone. A skittering puck off of Carl toward the corner. Matt Carl pursuing Rob Niedermeyer. Now that point shot deflected and then swatted away by Boucher. Langenbrenner has it back to Niedermeyer for a shot wide. All the way out to Motto. So the Devils look to set up the attack. For Ralston, back across White, but that puck hopped on him. All he could do is play it deep into the zone. He finds Langenbrenner, who gets to Ralston, who fires it wide. Now back out Motto. Down low. Spinning. Niedermeyer lost it. Edge went down as Carl got to him. And Carl will swat it up the wall, trying to get some help from Gagne to get it out of the zone, but it did not leave the zone. Ralston, quick shot, save. Boucher covers as Niedermeyer arrives on the scene. Best sustained pressure for the Devils in the game right there. There's the trivia question, the Jeep trivia question. We already showed it to you. The great save by Brian Boucher on Patrick Elias. What was the score in game 3 of that series when that save was made? 3-1, 2-1, or a 1-1 tie? Glad I didn't give that away, because I almost did when we were showing that save.
Gotcha.
Skula will flip that in along the wall. And now the battle in the corner. Kimmo Timonen. Linus Zubras back out. Skula shot, and that one took off and then found glass. No way Boucher could have seen it. There's a lot of traffic in front of him. Devils have really turned up the forechecking pressure here in the last 2 shifts. Timonen for Powell, and he'll redirect to center. Skula right back in. Elias reaching for it, teaming in, keeps it away from him. And Elias trying to turn that in front of the net. Coburn kept it out of there. Goes to Kovalchuk. Ilya Kovalchuk turning with it, dropping it back off for Zubris. Zubris in the corner, but Timonen steps in, but that one hit a skate, bounces free and out to center ice. Now Bryce Salvador moving it ahead. And the Devils, Kovalchuk dances around one and another, but then it's chopped away as Giroux got back. Pronger with a pass in the middle for Asham. Aaron Asham trying to work his way past. Paul Martin could not. The Flyers now, though, get the puck. It's Carl back to Bartulis. To Carl for a shot, deflected. Drew after the rebound, left away. Now Carl for Hartnell, around behind the net. Asham. He and Martin come together. The puck squibs to Green, who banks it ahead to LeBlanc. His cross-ice pass intercepted by Giroux. He's got some ice to work with. Giroux hit across the line. Swings wide to the right wing. Puck rolling on him and hopped over his stick. And then, as he tried to send it in front, it went off his stick and out of play. Bill, you talked about game one importance in this series in particular, but in general, you see how important it is. Flyers, when they win game one, they've won 20 of 28 times. The problem is at the bottom there. They haven't won game one in a while.
Lots of time left.
Indeed. But you think, in particular, this game one is important because of what happened in the regular season.
The Flyers, I think, clearly have momentum against the Devils. They feel good about their ability to beat them, to come from behind against them. I mean, Devils are the number one rated defensive team in the NHL, but it doesn't seem to scare the Flyers much this season.
Doing a job here, though, in the first period, as you saw at the top of your screen. It's been a while for the Flyers now in terms of just getting a shot on goal. They only have three for the game.
But that said, JJ, for all of the time that the Devils have spent in the Flyers zone, I think the Flyers have been really sound defensively. The Devils only have six shots on goal in spite of having some of their key guys spend most of their shifts in and around Brian Boucher. So good D by the Flyers.
And you bring up the defense. I don't think it's any secret, having Lemaire back, that that has a lot to do with the New Jersey Devils having such a great defensive scheme. They've always had the ability to be able to keep the shots down to a dull roar, let Brodeur see the puck, and having Lemaire back, that's the difference.
Here's Darryl Powell getting to the puck, moving up with Betts. A chance here. Powell, the shot deflected away by Green, who got over there to get his stick in the way. That was a two-on-one developing, but still couldn't get a shot on goal. Is a nice play made by Green. Does Jacques Lemaire once had a boat named the Trap, so he does know how to coach that system and even other defensive systems. Where
I'll tell you, that was a crab trap, though.
Here's Betts, a shot, save Brodeur. So the Flyers break their shot drought, and it's a real tester for Brodeur, but he denies Blair Betts. And now the Devils chip it ahead, a two-on-one developing. Zajac moving in. Zajac, the shot, save. Boucher, rebound, bounces free. Finally, Pronger playing it up, but not out of the zone. Zajac across, big shot, playing runner, and he fanned on it. Now from the angle, a shot, and Boucher the save, bouncing around in the slot. Betts could not clear. Skula with it. Cross ice it goes. Salvador in front, goes right on through. Back out for Skula. They'll just twist one in along the boards. Devils need a change, so the Flyers have some time. Longer ahead for Carl. And Carl will backhand. Didn't get that puck deep, and the Flyers are trying to change. Here's Zubris ahead for Elias. Coburn used his speed to get over. Now centered it. Front end. Kovalchuk jammed it wide. Salvador lays it back around behind the net. Elias to Skula. And good work there by Coburn. As he checks Zubris, and the Flyers will move it ahead. But Carter had it bounce off of him right to Elias. Moving in, shot, save. Boucher, rebound. Boucher dives on it. There will be a penalty. Ryan Boucher able to dive across, but there will be a penalty, and the Devils will go back to the power play.
Number 44 for Philadelphia.
As Timo heads to the box, Ryan Boucher, clearly the story of the first period here. Out far enough to cut down the angle, then to make the save. Kimmo Timonen trying to clear the front porch. But Boucher has now robbed Ilya Kovalchuk, Zach Parise, and Travis Zajac.
And he might have to come up with some more saves here with the Devils on the power play. 50 seconds remaining in the period. Here's Parise in the slot. Shot by Zajac. Pad save Boucher. Out it goes. Martin could not get it past Matt Carl.
He clears it all the way down. And the Devils. A half minute to work with in the period. Kovalchuk ramming it in. Skips to Pronger. He's checked. He is able to push the puck to the corner. Richards trying to protect it against two Devils. Gets some help from Carl. 15 seconds in the period. They chop away at it. Pronger comes in, leans on Parise. They have tangled all season long. Another Devil is dumped by Carl as Zubrus was sent flying, but no penalty. Crowd certainly wanted one. Brodeur catches that length of the ice offering, and that ends the first period. Ryan Boucher, the star of the show. He makes 9 saves, some real big ones. Brodeur not as busy. He stopped all 4 Flyer shots. No score through 20 minutes of play. Tonight's Flyers Devils first period was brought to you by McDonald's. Get a small premium roast coffee for 89 cents and a medium for just $1. McDonald's, I'm loving it. And by Kia Motors. Kia, the power to surprise. Here's our menu for the first intermission. We'll break down the game. We will. Also, we'll hear from Michael Barkan, Al Morgani back in the studios in Philadelphia with plenty of highlights and analysis. Right now, though, downstairs we go to Coatsy. He's with Claude Giroux.
Thanks very much, Jimmy. And, you know, when you take a look at that first period, obviously you guys matched the intensity of the New Jersey Devils.
Yeah, they came out pretty strong. They're at home, so they really want their fans going. But they've got to be disciplined because they're a very skilled team, obviously. So we did a pretty good job in the first, but we got to be better in the rest of the game.
Do you think that your confidence level, the longer it went in that first period as they turned the lights out on us here, is that, you know, the longer you can go in this hockey game and match that intensity, your confidence level will get greater?
Yeah, anytime it's the first game in playoffs, you really want to go intense and really win those battles early. And like I said, we had a pretty good first period, but I don't think it's going to be good enough. We got to work harder.
Claude, thank you very much.
Thanks.
Back up to you, Jimmy. Sorry the lights went out on us.
Hey, not your fault, Coatsy. Not your fault. We'll be back with more from North Jersey after these messages. No score after one. This portion of Flyers Hockey on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you by Chevrolet and your local Chevy dealers. No score through one period of play here at Prudential Center. Flyers and Devils, game one of this Eastern Conference quarterfinal series. And Bill, a tremendous pace from the get-go, the first 5 minutes in particular. Devils did take over a little bit of the territorial play as we moved along.
No, I thought the Flyers' start in an energy sense was good, but I think their attention to detail started to fall off a little bit. I mean, the Devils ended up with some really good scoring chances, point blank, because of, I think, lack of attention to detail in the neutral zone. When you got somebody that's got a head of steam on, you've got to pick them up visually, get your read on them, and make sure you angle them. That didn't happen. And as a result, Brian Boucher was able to confirm that it has not been a mirage that he has been putting together lately.
Yeah, what stayed strong throughout the period, great goaltending at both ends, but in particular Boucher.
Yeah, without a doubt, Brian Boucher's had a number of challenges. Number one, he had to scramble. Number two, he had to face one of the top snipers in all of hockey, in Ilya Kovalchuk. So Brian Boucher passed every test. The Flyers did not test Marty Brodeur as much. That said, had a couple of good scoring chances, and Brodeur was on top of his game, too.
And when you break down the playoff career totals, just about everybody, save Patrick Waugh, pales in comparison to Martin Brodeur. Brian Boucher, first time he started a playoff game since 2002, and that's how they've done tonight.
The one thing the Flyers did not come close to doing in that period that they want to do is establish their game from the hash marks in on offense. The Flyers think that they can forecheck the Devils, cycle the puck. When the Flyers are on top of their game and playing with that offensive passion, that's what you see. When they do that, they're going to test Marty Brodeur from all kinds of angles with shots into his feet. He doesn't go down into the butterfly, so if you get pucks at his feet, sometimes it's tough to deal with for a guy that stands up like that. The Flyers did not establish that in the first.
And it was very successful for them during the course of the regular season. So no score through one period of play here in North Jersey. The Flyers will try to get things going when period number two gets underway. When we come back, though, it'll be Michael Barkan, Al Morgani with their thoughts on period number one.
Playoff update at Pittsburgh. Game one, Senators, Penguins tied at 1 in the first. Off the faceoff, slap shot, bounces in the air, Chris Neal finds the rebound and beats Marc-Andre Fleury. Now in the second period, it is 3-1 Senators after one. But we are talking Flyers hockey during this intermission report. Al Morgani, Michael Barkan, and Al. 9 saves by Brian Boucher. That's the good news. The bad news is some odd man rushes, some defensemen getting beaten down ice a little bit, but Boucher standing tall against some pretty big guns of the Devils.
But let's look at it as the good news, because they weren't just the 9 saves. They were real quality saves against terrific players. You knew you were going to have to stop big guns, and one of them would be this guy right here. Alone in the slot, Kovalchuk, with people in front, with some sort of traffic in front, and Boucher throws a glove at him, just snares that thing, and this is a confident goaltender. There's a stick out there for, doesn't get the tip, but he's right there. He's in the slot alone. It's the worst scenario for a goaltender. Keeps his eye on it, snares the puck. He's right there. The other guy you wanted to keep your eye on, maybe the Flyers defenseman should keep a better eye on him, Zach Parise. He comes in from the side, from the left side, bulls his way in, takes the shot. Terrific stop by Brian Boucher. And you were a bit worried coming in. He's made big stops, but the Flyers, as you mentioned, can't keep doing that. Have to take, they're being forced wide in the offensive zone. They've got to get more plays behind the net, come inside. The Devils force you outside, inside-out game that they play. But the Flyers have to cycle and get some better offense going, too. And the good news is, though, they're killing a penalty. There's no better time than to kill half it at the end of a period.
Yeah, you like
to
begin.
Yeah, because then, like, Ian LaPerriere can kill the whole penalty. You're going to get a center ice face-off, so the puck, maybe you get the face-off, you kill some time there. It's the never a good time. They've taken, you can't keep giving them power play opportunities. But if you can kill half in one, then half in the other, half the job's already done.
Right.
Look at it that way.
Yeah. We're going to talk a little bit more about the power play. We're on Comcast Sportsnet right now, but we're going to pause. We'll send you back to normally scheduled programming on television. But when we come back on the internet, on CSNPhilly.com, Al Morgani has the whole power play situation down. Hang on. Let's take a deep breath, and we'll come back on the web.
Tonight's second period from the Prudential Center is brought to you by Acura Advance. And by Verizon Wireless, we never stop working for you. No scoring in that first period, Bill, but plenty of other numbers.
Yeah, some good scoring chances late in the period by the Devils. Out shooting the Flyers 9-4, faceoffs pretty even. Flyers out hit, but they spent a lot of time in their own end. The table is set for hitting when you're playing in your own end defensively.
And as the second period begins, let's head downstairs to Steve Coates.
Well, I had an opportunity to talk to assistant coach Joey Mullen, and I said, how do you feel that first period went? He said, too much east-west. As far as the passing's concerned, we need to get north-south and get in their zone and get pressure on their defense. They don't like that east-west stuff at all, because a lot of the passes are being intercepted.
Here's Brian Ralston with the puck in across the Philadelphia line. Takes it wide, and then the shot deflected by Pronger, and it goes out of play.
Now, I really believe that the team that spends the most time from the faceoff dots in the offensive zone, probably going to win this series. And Flyers did not establish their game. That's part of it.
The ice time leaders, you saw that both Chris Pronger and Matt Carl into double figures in just the first period. And they both made their presence felt, but that's a lot. They're on pace for obviously over 30 minutes in a regulation game. Kovalchuk backhanding that one behind the net. Carl jumbled up there, and Parise took the puck away, had his stick chopped away by Pronger, and then back to the point. It's tipped away by Richards. Dragging it ahead is Gagne. Richards with him in the 2-on-1. Gagne the shot. Save, Brodeur, rebound, Richards! And Brodeur got in the way of that as well. Back the other way go the Devils. Zajac with room. Dishes for Parise to Kovalchuk, getting free. The shot, save. Boucher, rebound up the outside of the post. Langenbrunner caught some iron, and the Flyers clear the zone.
Unbelievable chances at both ends. That's what the Flyers need to do on a 2-on-1. Drive the puck at Brodeur, then have somebody there for the rebound. Mike Richards got the rebound and forced him to make another save. And then Brian Boucher has got Ilya Kovalchuk muttering in Russian again.
Boucher will backhand that puck to the corner boards. Rob Niedermeyer, the veteran, after it, and comes away with the puck. Niedermeyer to the slot, a backhander wide. Now Rod Pelly tucked it out in front, but Scott Hartnell there to accept it. Hartnell missing Carter with that pass. Motto right back the other way looking for Pelly, but it eluded him, and Boucher will play.
Braden Coburn reversing it for Hartnell. And he'll whip one all the way across for Briere in center. Briere steps in across the Devil's line and deposits the puck deep in the zone. Motto bodied by Carter, but the puck sat right there for Pelly.
Troy, that second man is so important on the forecheck. Your first guy is going to take the body if he can get there quickly enough to make contact. Better have somebody there as a second guy to get the puck.
Giroux looking to move up, but that's taken away by Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk shot! Again, an answer from Brian Boucher as he accepts that one into his equipment. And here's some Bouch chants from some of the Flyer fans in attendance.
Flyers 2-on-1 moments ago with Simon Gagné and Mike Richards.
Brian Boucher has just been spectacular once again. Now watch. Right here, he's going to make the initial save, but look at that left pad come right back out. Now, oh yeah, it hit the side of the net. But the pad was there if the puck had been on net. That's all I care about. He is on his game.
Paul Martin knocked down by Aaron Asham. We're back to live action in the corner. Clarkson went crashing in, but Krejcik got the puck. Now it's Van Riemsdyk flipping to Giroux. Right back through Asham. He'll send one in off glass. Brodeur loves to play that puck. Gets it to the corner, but Asham's right there. Bounces off of Dean McKenna, the former Flyer. He's bodied by Giroux, but turns the other way and finds Martin waiting for him. Devils began this period on the power play as Timo Timonen had to finish up serving his minor. So they're now 0-for-2 in the power play. Flyers 0-for-1. A lot of 5-on-5 hockey in this one. And Salvador is back. Former St. Louis Blue defenseman. At the center and then was met by Gagné. And Martin will try. Martin surveying as he moves out from behind his net. And now Salvador for Ralston, and that one redirected all the way in the air to Boucher. He'll find Pronger. Pronger ahead, hoping for Carcillo, and Alan White had him in the cross there. Puck deflecting away, and Richard steals it for Philadelphia, but it's taken right back by Niedermeyer. Flipped it ahead. Langenbrenner's cross ice pass off a body picked up by Niedermeyer to Ralston. And he'll bounce it into the corner. Pronger and Niedermeyer come together. And we're teammates. Puck Carcillo. Carcillo couldn't control it. Goes back out to White with room. His wrist shot blocked off by Carl. Matt Carl trying to lead the charge, but he's met by Zajac. And Matt Carl will get back to it. That is Zajac. Really has developed into a fine all-around player for this Devils team.
Yeah, no kidding. Out of Dave Hackstall's North Dakota program, as is Zach Parise. He's as good defensively as he is offensively, too, Zajac is.
Timonen gets to this one in center ice. It's the kind of guy we'll notice seeing him day in and day out here in a long series more than we will maybe just seeing him once in a while during the season. That's around. That goes off with Perrier out into the high slot, but then drifts to center ice, and Coburn back to get it for Philadelphia. 4.5 in already in this second period. Still waiting for the first goal of this series. Coburn winds up in blast, gloved by Brodeur. He'll play it off this high stick of Carter. He just stuck his stick in the air with his back turned to the play, and it hit it.
Unbelievable.
So the whistle gives us a chance to tell you about Comcast Sportsnet, being your best source for inside access to the Flyers' fight for Lord Stanley's Cup. Get a complete breakdown with expert analysis. Flyers Devils Eastern Conference quarterfinals on the ultimate goal Thursday night, 10:30, only on Comcast Sportsnet. Brodeur has seen 9 shots thus far. Stopped them all. And they puck down, the Flyers control, and Bartoulis will send it in. Brodeur cuts it off. Tries the boards. Carter was waiting for that. Briere caught up by Aliash. He's able to punch it into the corner, but Salvador is there. Flyers swarm upon him, but now it's Martin Skoula. Good pickup by the Devils at the trade deadline. Much traveled defenseman, but a solid, steady player with a lot of playoff experience. He won a cup with Colorado. As Brodeur will set this up for Salvador. It's really a veteran-laden team. Think of Zach Parise. We do have some young players, but we were watching the team skate before the game. We were noticing that there's a...
They're older than the Flyers.
Yeah, veteran element to this team. Here's Claude Giroux, out of the Flyers. Youngsters moving on up, but he's stopped by McCammon. Gotten back by Van Riemsdyk. Surges in with it. Van Riemsdyk around behind the Devil's net. Gets it back out to Carl. Carl No lane there, so he'll just roll it in along the dasher to Asham. Aaron Asham centering Van Riemsdyk, a poke at it, but the Devils snuff that out. But here's Kovalchuk. Rink wide looking for Andy Green, getting him, but across game, Pronger to knock it away. He covers so much territory, Chris Pronger. And now Asham with a lot of room to work with. Asham in across the Devils' line, curl and drag, and the shot and the stick save for Brodeur. That one didn't have a whole lot on it. It was deflected on the way in. And the Devils clear.
Much better, though, by the Flyers. They're getting pucks deep, establishing a forecheck.
Giroux with a pass for Hartnell in the middle. That's deflected away. Now Hartnell leans on Zajac, but Zajac protected the puck well. Moves the puck to White. And from the red line, he'll send one deep to Philadelphia ice. Boucher is right there, quickly moving it. Carl around for Hartnell. And ahead to Carter. And Jeff Carter flings in from the red line. Steadier pace to this second period. Not as frenetic. As the systems certainly being employed by both clubs. And the Flyers with the advantage in shots heavily. 6-2, and they're going to get another one here perhaps as Carter moves on in. No, he stopped. Now he centers, but no one home for Philadelphia. And the red jersey Devils go the other way. Langenbrenner dropping it for Ralston. The play is offside. Early on, second period, still no.
Neil Hartman with an update on the Pens and the Sens. Not a lot of scoring hit North Jersey tonight, but plenty of scoring at the Igloo in Pittsburgh. A guy named Malkin scoring here late in the second period to pull the Penguins within one. It's 3-2 Sens in the second. Back to North Jersey.
All right, Neil, thank you very much. All the goals in Pittsburgh tonight. And you see that matchup, 4-5. It's interesting, the 4-5 matchup in 1-8. The fours have won almost as many games over the last 15 years as the ones. The big upset series has been the 2-7, where 14 times over the last 30 series, it's been the number 7 seed. That's almost a 50-50 split.
We understand that Ottawa's now made it 4-2. I wondered if they were going to be able to score enough goals against Pittsburgh and to keep up with Pittsburgh's offense. So far, so good for the Sens.
Richard centered that one and went off of Carcillo's stick to the corner. Neil Hartman will keep us abreast, of course, of what's developing there. That puck off of Brodeur at the side of the New Jersey net. And now ahead, this one goes, skipping past Clarkson all the way down. No icing. Carl will beat Clarkson to the puck. And now turn back and set up a rush for Philadelphia. Braden Coburn rips it in from the red line. Skitters around to Gagne. He'll turn it back around behind the net. Brodeur gathers there. Finds the other side of the ice. Pronger was there. Back around. Now Green. Bumped by Powell, who swept the puck away from him. Now Carl in from the point back around behind. A penalty upcoming. Wes McCauley has his arm in the air. The Devils are guilty of a hook. And the Flyers will get their second power play.
Number 8, New Jersey, minor penalty, hooking.
Well, former Flyer Dinah Zubris is the guy that's going to pick up the penalty here, right along the wall. Remember when this young guy came in as a draft pick out of Junior B. Let's see if we can pick up right here. No. There, he just got rid of the stick up underneath the arm.
Got that stick in a bad spot. It wasn't there for long, but the Flyers will take the power play. And the Devils will clear the zone. And Zuby was pointing out that we've been around a long time, Coatsy. We were talking to him today. But you guys still going? Dinah Zubris is now 31 years old. We've all aged. He still looks the same as he did when he was a kid. Funny how that happens. And Ralston. Able to backhand out to center ice.
Well, the Flyers are going to have to ramp up their battle readiness on these power plays. They also have to move the pucks faster. I mean, the Devils are so quick to pursue and to pressure. The only way to defuse that is by moving pucks really quickly.
Well, they try to win the battle at retrieval first of all here, and they do that. Gagne spinning to the other side. Progress to race over. He gets there to keep it in. Quick pass. Now it comes across to Richards. Richards fanning on the shot. It's still loose. It dribbles wide of the net. Now Richards back after it. Skula checks him, but Richards finds Giroux quickly out to Timonen. There's your quick puck movement right back down to Giroux. Well, Giroux has a look. Here's to Richards. Richards centers. Gagne poke at it. Loose puck. They score!
Pronger was in the middle, jamming away, and eventually it dribbles across the goal line, and the Flyers take the lead 1-0 on the power play goal as they score for a case of Tasty Cakes.
And this had a little bit of everything. First of all, quick puck movement. That got the Devils standing still. Then it allowed the Flyers to get the puck down low and get it into Marty Brodeur's feet with the low shots that we talked about. Then it was up for grabs because Brodeur is not a butterfly goalie.
And the second thing, very important, it was Pronger that held that puck in originally from the blue line and then end up being in front of the net to score the goal. The guy's all over the place.
You know what, Marty Brodeur was a little bit all over the place. When you're not a butterfly goalie, you don't go down and seal off all of those low areas. You could see from that angle behind the net that he was kind of on his knees, but didn't have much of the net covered.
So the Flyers get the first goal. They wanted that badly in this game, and they've got it, even though it is almost halfway through regulation time when the first puck goes into a net here tonight. Matt Carl back for the icing touch up here. Pronger describing that power play. Gets his 23rd career playoff goal, 103rd playoff point.
I got news for you. You know, we talk about Chris Pronger's reach all the time and how dynamic it is defensively. It's just as valuable offensively. Now he's going to outreach people in front too.
That angle, the best look. You could see it go right off of Ralston and in. Gagne and Richards with the helpers at 9:25. Flyers look for more here. Krejcik hit across the Devils line, but he's cut off by Martin, whose pass is to Kovalchuk. 2-on-1. Kovalchuk with Zubris. There's Zubris, the shot. Boucher sliding across, makes the save. No further play. He was all over that one. And Chris Pronger all over the crease here. Dirty but good. Flyers lead 1-0. The lead courtesy of Chris Pronger's power play goal as we pass the midpoint of regulation time in this game. Andy Green with the pass to the right wing, and Patrick Elias heels back and then dumps it deep into the Philadelphia zone. Richards will play it to the boards. Rubis is over after it to Elias, trying to set her, but Thiemann jabs that one away. Gagne spots Carcillo. Left wing dish too hot to handle for Richards, and the Devils have it back. And the Flyers get in on the forecheck here, try to cause that Devils defense some difficulty. Martin is one of their defensemen that has great mobility, though. He's able to move it ahead, and here come the Devils. Develops into a 3-on-2, but a great play by Coburn. Broke it up and sets Coburn off the other way to Richards, to Coburn, or I should say to Carcillo. His pass for Gagne tipped away. Carcillo has it back, and he's dumped by White. White
paid the price, though.
Several meetings here.
Carcillo paid the price to make a really nice play.
Dancing down the ice, Kovalchuk shot, but everything but the finish. He fired it wide.
Wow, Kovalchuk full bore right there, but could not find the target.
And oh, by the way, that's the defensive matchup the Flyers wanted against him.
That has this crowd amped up for the first time since the Flyers scored. Betts. We'll get to LaPerriere. Now Powell. Powell backhand in. Turning is Salvador. Powell rides him into the boards. LaPerriere arrives with the puck the other way. Ryan Ralston banks it in. And goes and gets it. Krejcik gets to him, and Betts takes the puck. Reverses to Krejcik. Less than 8 minutes remaining now in this second period. That's for Bartulis. It went off his stick. Hartnell is able to reach and backhand it into the Devils zone. I wonder what point, Bill, the fact that Flyers won 5 of 6 and now have the lead starts to enter into the Devils thinking. Well, here we go again kind of thing.
Not sure that they're thinking overall right now. You're in the moment of the game. Depending on how long the score stays like this, and if the Flyers can win game one, then it's a real deal.
Salvador's shot, save. Boucher. Whistle blew quickly. Boucher was able to cover and then ends up with Clarkson literally on his back.
Here is why Ilya Kovalchuk is so dangerous. If he gets his speed in the neutral zone, he can beat not just one good defensive player, but two of them.
How about guys that don't lose speed, but still have to be able to keep that same speed, carry the puck, beat two people, and then look up. Look at his head. Watch this. He's looking up. He's looking for that far corner, but he's so mad because he missed the corner. But the European player is so good at shooting with their head up, looking where they wanted to shoot it, and that's why Kovalchuk was so mad.
And his bread and butter area of the ice, yeah, it's when he's in shooting range, but it's between the blue lines. That is the speed zone of hockey. And if the Flyers can deny him space between the blue lines, won't be able to be as threatening. He said five scoring chances. If nothing else, he might be getting upset because his arms are getting tired.
Has not been able to solve Boucher. Boucher has made some big saves. That particular try went wide, still a scoring chance.
And Bouch was well out of the net to cut down the angle, reading that Kovalchuk had nobody to pass to.
Arcillo on a one-on-two rush here. He takes some more punishment as Andy Green got a healthy piece of it. Now Martin worked on by Richards. A diving play. Nearly got that puck free. In fact, he did. To Carcillo, back for Richards. Right to center, but Green loses his gloves to knock it down. Gagne then, the heavy hit on Green, and teaming it in to get the puck. Mapped up by Eliash. Nice scrum. Gagne hoping that puck will pop free. And it does, but then he has a double to deal with. Gagne still getting that puck to teaming in. Teaming in, trying to center. Blocked off by Brodeur at the side of the net. Martin has it up the wall for Kovalchuk. His pass is to Eliash. One player back for the Flyers is a forward. Eliash to Zubris. Zubris angle drive off of Timonen and wide. Kept in by Mono. It deflects off of Eliash. White thought about going in after it, but then peeled back, and Coburn gets to it. Finds Timonen, and he'll wind it deep into the double zone. Brodeur all the way up the middle looking for LeBlanc, and he'll lay it in. Rugged, tough guy forward in the lineup for the Devils. Giroux poking that puck out to center ice. Asham's there. Asham back to Giroux. Giroux, fancy move, turn shot! And I think Brodeur might have gotten a piece of that one to knock it away. You have to remember, too, Claude Giroux, all of 22 years of age and only his second playoff series.
The bright lights of the playoffs have really paralyzed his brain, haven't they? Oh, man.
He tried several of those last year against Pittsburgh, too, if you recall. He was not intimidated by the playoff atmosphere whatsoever. 9:35 remaining in this quickly moving second period. Carl wants it ahead into the Devils' zone.
Now, Coach, he talked about Joey Mullen, Flyers assistant coach, when Coach talked to him between periods about north-south. The Flyers have changed that up completely, are chipping pucks in. That is how they've established their forecheck. They're not worrying about passes from side to side as much, other than that one right there.
The Clement curse. Here's Oscar Bartulis moving it out to center. Bounced back in by Skula wide of the net. Oscar Bartulis will settle things down. There's a Decato, a long stretch pass to Hartman, spinning back with it, and then decides just to dump it down low in the double zone. But it goes to Krajicek. He'll flip one off of Hartnell's stick to the corner. Riera's check. Hartnell pursuing. He gets pinned up against the glass by Zajac. They continue to battle, and now it's Colin White tracking it down. The veteran defenseman, veteran of two cup-winning teams here in New Jersey. D'Amato ahead. Clarkson knocked down by Timonen just as the puck was getting there. Some of the fans thought maybe a little before the puck got there. Now it's LaPerriere. That one over his stick to Martin. Green at ahead, knocked down by Powell. Now rubbed out by Zajac. Poked ahead by Green, and then Clarkson twisted it into the Philadelphia zone. But right there's Coburn. Ahead for LaPerriere. And he was met by Martin. And moving ahead with it, Zubris. Zubris wide on the left wing. And he used that strength of his, and then decked by Coburn.
Tripped over the side of the net, I think.
And at the side of the net, Parise got a couple cracks at it. Turnaround shot, Parise went wide. And Betts will try to clear, but could not. Parise has it again. Pass tipped. Now the centering feed for Zubris goes all the way through. And LaPerriere will bank it out to center.
As long as the Flyers do a good job getting pucks quickly and efficiently out of their zone, you're not going to notice. Oh, look at this.
Richards a shot. Oh. He scores! Ian LaPerriere, the steal, the great pass, and Richards the finish. And it's 2-0 Philadelphia. Oh. Richards scores for a case of Tasty Cakes.
What?
A laser by Mike Richards, undetectable to the naked eye. I mean, he had to shoot this thing 100 miles an hour, but it was all about Ian LaPerriere. Jammed his way along the boards and it teed Richards up perfectly.
Well, Ian LaPerriere is going to fool everybody here with this back pass. Look at this. And then all of a sudden, it's basically a two-on-two. Salvador doesn't go to Richards, so he lets them shoot. So he has allowed the opportunity, but here comes that backhand, and Richards doesn't have to stop. He just gets that pass right onto the tape and winds up and lets it go. A simple two-on-two, and all of a sudden, it's a 2-0 hockey game.
Flyers moving back in. They've now scored goals on each of their last two shots. Carcillo tries to make it 3-for-3, but he lasered that one wide. Krajicek now behind for Gagne, but he was checked. Dean McCammon picks it up. And now it's Martin outletting Pelly. Rod Pelly to the Philadelphia line. Stop and go, and then shuttles it around for McCammon. McCammon working away from Asham. His pass, though, knocked down by Van Riemsdyk, who spots Giroux moving up. He'll chip and chase.
In deep, in deep, in deep. It's how the Flyers have established their game, and now with a 2-0 lead, it's even more important that they do that.
Matt Carl is back. He'll roll it up the wall all the way out to center ice. Alan White with the puck with 2.5 to play here in the second. Shots are 13-12 in favor of the Devils for the game. Offside, the call on New Jersey. We'll step aside. Richards off the feed from LaPerriere. Blows it past Brodeur. The Flyers up by 2.
Here's an update from Pittsburgh. They're in the second period intermission. Ottawa scored late in the second period to take a 4-2 lead. Eric Karlsson with the power play goal for the Sens, who lead the Penguins 4-2. Let's send it back to the Prudential Center.
Ed Snyder, Flyers chairman, has to be happy with the events of this second period as his Flyers have taken a 2-0 lead.
And they've earned their scoring chances as well. They didn't deserve many scoring chances in the first period, but they've established their game.
This will be icing on New Jersey if Carl can beat Niedermeyer to the puck, and he does. Let's take a look at that goal again and the fantastic setup by Ian LaPerriere.
Yeah, this is how the Devils got themselves in trouble. It was Martin School of the, I don't know, if he was looking for a five-hole there, he was a little high on the body. And Mike Richards with the blast that Marty Brodeur got a piece of. Cause for high fives for Mr. Ed Snyder.
That's what they call a perfect counterattack. When all of a sudden you can intercept that puck and come the other way, and boy, did they make the best of that. Simple two-on-two, Billy. That's just unbelievable.
Langenbrenner a shot here. Save Boucher. Puck rolling back toward Bouch as he has to deal with some heavy traffic, and he covers up, and then some pushing and shoving out in the slot area.
I want to remind everybody that the first home game in this Flyers-Devils series is Sunday at 6 p.m. Note the start time, 6 p.m. Then next Tuesday at 7:30 p.m. Tickets for all round one home games are on sale right now. Call 800-298-4200 or visit PhiladelphiaFlyers.com. Great seats available. Representatives are standing by right now to take your call. Pick up the phone and come and join the playoff party.
Does not get any better than the Stanley Cup playoffs. There's a point shot off the draw, blocked. Andy Green gets it back, tries again. It ends up as a pass to Zubers. And then Parisi on the doorstep could not pound it home. Bounces high in the air. Where will it land? Right out in front. And it's finally Blair Betts who fishes it out of there. Well, back headed across from LaPerriere. No one really knew where that puck was going to come down. It landed in a dangerous area. But the Flyers live to tell about it. Here's Betts off the side of the net. And that's going to set the Devils going the other way. And Parisi will wind it in. Off of Zubris, back out. Zajac gets a redirection. And Boucher was able to take care of that off the stick of Parise. He didn't have much on it by the time it made its way to him, as we come to you from the Prudential Center here in Newark. Along with our great crew, glad to be bringing you game one of this Eastern Conference quarterfinal series on Comcast Sportsnet. Richards sends it in as we tick down toward a minute remaining in this second period. It's been a fruitful period for the Flyers.
Quiet building here except for Flyers fans.
Yeah, you can hear the Flyers fans. They are into it now. Big hit there by Carcillo. Kovalchuk and Langenbrunner, Coburn all in the vicinity. It'll squirt free. There's a broken stick over in that corner. Timonen navigates his way around that, sends it off the stick to center. Richards gets it back. Richards hit across the line. Wakes his pass for Gagne. He was there, but Kovalchuk got his stick on it. Now Gagne after it in the corner. And finally, it's worked away from a prone Dan Carcillo. Kovalchuk looks to start the Devils the other way. His pass for Eliash, though, off the mark, and Carl will lay it back ahead for Carcillo, who jams it into the Devils' zone.
Are there three Matt Carls wearing number 25, or is he just everywhere?
He really has been
what
impressive.
What a game! Not only defensively, but offensively, too. He'll just show up on the blue line to keep a rush alive.
It's seldom you notice a defenseman as much as we're noticing him in a positive way. Sometimes you notice him in a negative way, but he's been great. So has Boucher. And the Flyers, as the second period comes to an end, take a two-goal lead to the intermission. Boucher has stopped all 15 shots he's seen. Brodeur's been beaten twice on 12 offerings from the Flyers, one of them off the stick of this guy. Tonight's Flyers-Devils second period was brought to you by Suzuki and the amazing Kizashi Sports Sedan. Also brought to you by Metro PCS. Here's what we have for you between periods 2 and 3. Michael Barkan, Al Morgani will be back with you. Bill and I will have our say as well. Plenty of highlights and analysis of a night that's gone well for the Flyers thus far. Downstairs we go to Steve Coates. He's with Ian LaPerriere.
Thanks very much, Jimmy. And there's proof that a lot of people don't know that you had 96 assists in your last year of junior, and it's that kind of play that reminds us all of that.
Even at broken clocks, right, twice a day. I don't know, I just saw Richie there, and I was telling him after the goal, you know, if I miss that, I'm sitting on the bench for the rest of the game. And it's one play, you know, I take a little chance, but it paid for us.
There's something different about this team in the last 2 weeks. What do you think it is?
I don't know, we're on the same page, I think. You know, we've shown flashes of what we can do. And even in the first, that was in the way we wanted to start. We started to show a little bit more in the second. We'll need a lot more in the third, and hopefully we'll have more of that coming up.
Lappy, thanks very much, and once again, great Pat.
Thanks.
Back up to you guys.
Flyers 2-0 in game one of the Stanley Cup playoffs against the Devils. Al Morgani, Michael Barkan. Wow, what a second period. And Al, you know, we expected them to be competitive. I don't know if you could have expected that onslaught, starting with a Chris Pronger power play goal and then ended with an unbelievable defensive play from Ian LaPerriere.
Couldn't ask for any more. This is Pronger. I mean, you knew coming into this series, Pronger was going to be key. And there you see him in front. He's got to have the nerve to come into the play. There's one thing about moving up in a play as a defenseman, quite another to be where Pronger is on this play. But he take advantage of it. Pronger goes for it. He sees it. He's going to be covered for us, so the Flyers are doing their job. And right there in the crease, and it's a nice tip, boys. There's soft hands for that big man there.
Off a Ralston skate.
This is just beautiful. This is Ian LaPerriere on Skula. He takes Skula to Skula on the boards here. This is just beautiful. Skula gets inside, then nice.
Pass.
What a pass. And then Richards launches the rocket. And Marty's got to start to think now. This is just a beautiful play. Look at him. Look at it. Cranks right in. Ian's all excited. When he gets excited, it's electric. Everybody catches on. The Devils starting to come apart a little bit here.
And but then Brian Boucher on the other end, Al.
Yeah, they had their chances. And this is Kovalchuk early in the period when they could have easily got back in the game on a power play. Bouch makes that terrific save. And Boucher's made big saves on big players. Again, Kovalchuk pass over. Beautiful play. Boucher over to cover up. Now watch this one. This is with traffic in front. So it's not just the one man coming in here. Bouch in traffic with people around him. He sees everything. Players falling around him. That's a confident goaltender right now. Now you got to think the Devils are starting to maybe play a little bit individual. Not a case before, but with Kovalchuk on the team, it looks like they're just a little bit starting to come undone. One goal gets him in, but boy, the Flyers just played a great, great period.
And you heard what Ian LaPerriere said to Coates. He said, we're starting to get it now. We're gelling. We come together now, and I guess that's certainly in the nick of time.
A lot of that is when your goaltender's playing like that, it's funny how your goaltender plays like that, all of a sudden things start to happen really well, and he has really played well for them.
All right, what are they going to do in the third period to hold on to this lead and come away with a game one win? CSNPhilly.com right now. We'll see you post-game, though.
Flyers 2, Devils no score as we await the start of third period action here in North Jersey. And welcome back. Bill, a great second period for the Flyers. They had better chances. They capitalized on two of them. And the second goal in particular is one where a lot of things went well for the Flyers.
Well, the Flyers are opportunists on that goal. But besides that, they really established their game. And that was what was important to me. But here is the play that the Flyers scored on. Ian LaPerriere is going to cut this clearing attempt from Martin Skoula off. And while he did that, Blair Betts had decided that he just wanted to go for a change. Here's Blair Betts heading to the bench. You notice Mike Richards is not even on the ice yet. So by the time LaPerriere over on the left gets the puck, here comes Mike Richards, and he is just going to head to position A. He hung out in front of the bench long enough not to be called for a too many men on the ice penalty. Ian LaPerriere, man, I'll tell you what, that's pretty good x-ray vision when you know that there's a guy coming across the ice from the bench. Mike Richards might have been yelling, but he's usually quiet. You know, I wouldn't expect Mike Richards to do that.
Great awareness by LaPerriere, and he is a true playoff warrior, and really coming up big in this game. He's having a great contest, as are a lot of the Flyers. So LaPerriere's set up. Mike Richards has Philadelphia up by two as we approach third period action. Tonight's third period on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you by the Pennsylvania Lottery. Benefits older Pennsylvanians every day. Must be 18 or older to play. Please play responsibly. And by your local Chevy dealers. So far, so good for the Flyers. There's your summary of the second period. Pronger gave the Flyers the lead, and then 7 minutes and 2 seconds later, with no shots in between, Mike Richards made it 2-0.
And the Flyers really evened up a lot of these numbers after the first period. They were lopsided in the Devils' favor. Not any longer, especially because the Flyers established their game, which is a down low offensive forechecking pressure kind of game that Peter Laviolette really wants to see. The Devils play a very similar game, and I'll say this again. I think the series will be won by the team that plays the most in the offensive zone from the faceoff dots in.
This Pronger is used to this kind of thing, being in the playoffs 14 years in a row, and he rises to the occasion this time of year. All right, underway in the third period. The Flyers try to get game one. That puck ends up catching the safety netting off the glass, so no penalty. It's off to the left of Boucher coming up.
Smart play by Kimmo Timonen, and he shot it around the glass and had it climb up the glass and then go over.
103 points. He and Patrick Elias among players who are still in the playoffs. The 16 teams right now are right up there in the top five. Flyers will move the puck up here. It's a two-on-two. Richards and Carcillo. Pronger joining the rush. So is Carl. And the pass is for Carl. Both defensemen joining that rush. And now the pass goes off the mark. So you have forwards back, Gagne and Richards. And Pronger also getting back to take the puck. Downstairs we go. Steve Coates.
Thanks very much, Jimmy. And talking to Joey Mullen once again, the assistant coach of the Flyers. They want to keep the pedal to the metal here. They don't want to lay up and just sit back. They're going to keep coming out to the Devils and continue to play the way they have in the first two periods.
And to do that, part of the secret is going to be efficiently getting the puck out of their zone, just like they did on that play.
It was icy, but it's quite obvious from that first rush up the ice. Guys, when Matt Carl and Chris Pronger join, they're still going forward. They're not sitting back.
But that tells me that they're feeling really good, too. I mean, you don't have it every game. People might think you feel great every game. You don't. There's some nights where you just have so much energy and so much jump in your legs. That's what Pronger and Carl have tonight.
because Matt Carl had it the other night too.
Yes, he did. Ongane battling, just trying to get that puck out of the zone. Moved it out to Carcillo, and he's able to swing it into the New Jersey zone. Flyers will change as Colin White jumps to Philadelphia ice. Right there is Carl. Making it to Coburn. Now back to Carl. Back ahead to Darryl Powell. Powell using his speed to skate the puck to center, but then he's rubbed out by Zajac. Coburn goes back to get the puck from Philadelphia. 90 seconds into period number three. Lerbech with room to work with. A left wing feed for Powell. Hit shot, an easy stick save for Brodeur up into the safety netting.
Talking about Matt Carl, so much of it has to do with his positioning and his decisions. This was early in the game. He came right up into the face of Ilya Kovalchuk, got knocked down and still came back and made a good defensive play. Then on a penalty kill, surrounded by two Devils, no problem. Blocking shots, playing solid one-on-one down low. Moving pucks up efficiently.
Here's Bartulis with a shot off the outside of the post. That one may have caught something on the way in. And Brodeur did not appear to see it. Flyers that close to a 3-0 lead. And Carl rising to the occasion. Look at his bio and Anchorage, Alaska native.
Proud Alaskan, full of family values. Stand for the right things. I've said this before too. The building could be on fire, or he could have just won a $1 billion lottery. And by his facial expression and demeanor, you wouldn't know the difference.
You could not tell. Eddie Briere giving Martin Skoulas some difficulty in the Devil's zone. Carter joins in the scrum. Meanwhile, leaning on him, the puck bounces free, and finally it is Skoula to Pelly. Pelly will lay it ahead. Clarkson got hit up high penalty. Clarkson got caught with a stick. He went right to the Devil's bench. This could be 4 minutes. They'll check Clarkson to see if there's blood. There's blood on his hands.
Wes McCauley's over there right away to see if Clarkson's got the bleeding going on. And Stephen Watkins, the one that's going to make the call.
Number 3, White, double minor, high sticking.
Crowd reacting to the announcement of a double minor out of the Stars Bartulis.
Right in the middle of your screen. Oscar Bartulis went for the stick lift. The puck wasn't there. Clarkson moved his stick. Just as Bartulis went to lift it.
Right in the beak. Point of this hockey game right here, and Kovalchuk fanning on a pass gives LaPerriere a chance to clear the zone.
The Flyers do anything on this kill. They have to do their best to take away Kovalchuk's shot.
Here's Elliott. He set things up, spins back. Now Mark set a point to Kovalchuk. Pass could not be handled by Parise. Back by Elliott, looking to return to Parise. The Flyers had that covered in Bass. Tried to clear, Martin kept it in, and now it's batted by LaPerriere out to center ice. Volleyball player is Ian LaPerriere.
Once again, the Flyers are doing a great job of pressuring, not allowing the Devils the opportunity to set up on the perimeter.
Kovalchuk across for Green. Clarkson behind the net. Back out to Kovalchuk. Zajac couldn't knock that one down. In comes Green around behind for Zajac. Now out to Kovalchuk, winds his pass. Too hot to handle for Green, puts it in front, Clarkson tipped it. It went off of Boucher and then wide of the net, and then Gagne able to clear.
Nice quick changes for the Flyers, 20, 25 seconds. If you get the puck down the ice, get fresh troops out. You're going to be rotating the same guys for 4 minutes, probably three sets of forwards, two sets of D-men.
Carl back, beats Zajac to the puck, but then the Devils swarm to it. Kovalchuk to Martin. Martin to the wide and fired block. Who else? Ian LaPerriere laying out, and then it goes into the safety netting.
Ian LaPerriere, to me, is the best in the NHL at not telegraphing when he's going to go down. Watch him waving with his hand here. He was waving, sort of telling, you know, almost decoying Martin that, hey, I'm trying to direct my guys, my troops. In reality, he was setting Martin up for the shot on the block.
I'm really surprised Martin still took the shot. He had his head up and still saw LaPerriere there. Very surprising. Usually it's a matter of the guy having his head down, because you got to have your head down to take the slap shot. But yeah. Martin's head was still up and took the shot.
That's a good point. I wonder if he thought he could miss him.
Clarkson
getting some repairs. He was out on the power play. He is a hockey player after all.
He's a tough hockey player.
Yes, he is. Now time called as Zach Parise has to go get a new stick from the Devils bench. 2:29 remaining on the double minor to Bartulis. That's Zajac on the draw. And it's Parise back to Kovalchuk, who blasts, blocked, and punched, but not out of his own by Tiedemann. Martin's there across Kovalchuk, one-timer, and that one deflected and went wide. Through the slot. Tiedemann wrapping up Parise. But to the other side, Kovalchuk gets down in the zone to get to it, but his pass ends up going to center ice. Martin will have to drift back with it. Parise enters the Philadelphia zone. The second half of the double minor gets underway. Kovalchuk, the Langenbrunner, wheels out with it. Hold shot, blocked and cleared by Parker, but not out of the zone as Kovalchuk kept it in. Zajac around behind Parise. This steer to Kovalchuk. In along, Langenbrunner in front, bounces free. Parise after it, save. Boucher gathers the puck. No further play. Although there will be further pushing. Nothing too serious.
So it took the Devils almost 2.5 minutes before they forced Brian Boucher to make a save. That's successful penalty killing. Well, the Flyers continue their pursuit of the Cup this Sunday and next Tuesday at the Wachovia Center. Great seats still available. 800-298-4200 or visit PhiladelphiaFlyers.com. Devils finally resorting just to throwing pucks out front and hoping to outnumber the Flyers, but Brian Boucher was there, the human vacuum on that one.
Eliash misfires with that shot. Back to live action, and who else? Matt Carl fishing it out of the skates of Green and clearing.
Unbelievable.
If you've noticed that every time that puck comes into the area of Brian Boucher, he's in front of it all the time. That's that same anticipation we saw in the Sean Zubers earlier in the hockey game.
1:10 remaining on the power play. All over, accepts the hit, but the Devils able to get to the puck this time. Green at the point, skates it in along the boards. Looks for Eliash, but Carl swept it away from him. Gagne got interfered with, but was not seen, and so the Devils continue to hold the puck. Clarkson, hidden by Coburn. Zubras tipping it back. Ralston almost lost it to center, kept it in. Now Green all the way across to Eliash. Eliash back across Green, settles it, shot. And Boucher makes the save, a rebound, comes back out in front and hits Boucher. He didn't know where it is. He's pushed into the net, but the puck is not. Ryan Boucher somehow, someway, keeps it out of the net again.
Well, I'll tell you, and I think at least one of these ping pong pucks in front bounced off the Flyer and just about went in.
I don't believe Boucher knew it hit him. It still stayed up.
Just a superb job of penalty killing, though. As Coachy's pointed out, Boucher in perfect position. Wasn't able to control that rebound.
Look at his pads, though. Watch his pads when he comes back across. He's going to dangle that left pad and make sure that the right pad comes straight across. But still, look at that. That left pad gets the original puck, the original save, but his right pad takes care of the rebound on the other post.
That was the one. It was Gagne. It went off Gagne and just got stuck under Boucher's pad.
I was trying to clear it off that draw. Tiedemann's clear was knocked down. LaPerriere couldn't get it out of the zone either. 24 seconds remain in the power play for the Devils. But here's Parise. Back out. Kovalchuk had hopped over a stick. This is one frustrated hockey player right now. I'm going to try to take out some of that frustration right now as he sends it. But guess what? Zach Parise was ahead of him. Offside is called. Still 9 seconds on the power play. After the game, get the most extensive game breakdown with expert analysis and exclusive team reaction on Flyers post-game live presented by McDonald's. Everybody on the coverage. Michael Marquette, Al Morganti, everybody here on site after the game right here on Comcast Sportsnet as we'll dissect this one. It's been a good night for the Flyers thus far. This guy has had a lot to do with it.
Nobody goes home, and we will not be undersold. Or something like that.
Something like that.
What a kill for the Flyers. Everybody had a piece of it, and finally Brian Boucher did too.
And out of the box, jumps Bartulis to find the puck in his skates. He'll just dump it to the Devils line. So 13:40 to play in the third. Flyers still up 2-0 as they navigate their way through 4 minutes of shorthanded time. They're chopping that one. It's knocked down and now played by Mike Motto. Hobie Baker Trophy Award winner. Trophy winner, I should say, as he moves that ahead. Bouncing puck. McCammon to the corner. Now McCammon is shot, deflected by Carl, and out of play it goes. Just about 7 minutes into the third period, Brian Boucher continues to hold the fort. And it's still 2-0 Philadelphia.
Here's an update on the 5-4 matchup in the Stanley Cup playoffs tonight in Pittsburgh. The Senators took a 5-3 lead on Jarkko Ruutu's goal, but the Pens have just scored. There's 2 minutes and change to go, and it's 5-4. Pittsburgh trails.
All right, Neil. Good finish set up there. See how dramatic the finish is here, but right now the goaltending advantage Philadelphia thus far.
Another good example right there of the Flyers getting out of their zone.
Gagne centering, but unable to get his stick on. That was Giroux. And here come the Devils. Rob Niedermeyer charging in. Flips one off Boucher's stick. McCammon, backhand. Coburn knocked it down, but the Devils gather. McCammon will get it back to Niedermeyer. Coburn tangles with him. Niedermeyer trying to get it back to the point, but that's red and stolen by Gagne. He'll get the red line. Couldn't get that pass green as the Flyers wanted to change. Instead, it's Niedermeyer going the other way. His pass fails to connect with McCammon. Behind the net, McCammon and Giroux after it. Comes free to Colin White in. Angle shot. Went off a stick right on through the slot. Mike Motto in. Centers. That goes off Carl all the way to the other side. Kovalchuk roaming after it. Now it's Kovalchuk all the way around to the other side. All the way back out to the point. Finally takes the shot. Ryan Boucher is ready for that one. And accepts it and takes the whistle. Well, here's the answer to tonight's Jeep trivia question of the game. The score was 2-1 Flyers when Brian Boucher made that incredible save on Patrick Elias in game three of the 2000 Eastern Conference Finals.
If there's any questions about how many Flyers fans are here, every time that Boucher makes a save, you can hear the Boosh call from the upper deck. That means there's a lot of them here.
Thought that was you, Coatsy.
I was leading them.
At a point,
you cheerleader, you. But you're not in the upper deck. You're right down on ice.
Well, I got the long pom poms down here.
Okay. Colin White back to pick it up for the Devils. A lot of things have been said about Coatsy. Long pom poms. That's probably the first time we've heard that one. The puck skips free. Here's a turnover. LePerrière to Betts, and he'll backhand it around behind. Brodeur will steer to the boards. To the point, but not out. Thiemann is there. Back it along, and the Devils will corral the puck. 11 and a half remaining.
But a little time spent in the Devil's zone, and not much of that lately.
Kovalchuk.
A minute ago, Gagne could have got the puck in deep, turned it over, and the Devils came back the other way.
Look out there. In nick of time getting to it. But Elias centers Linkenbrenner. Couldn't get a lot on the shot. Now he's got it. The net is off its moorings. And we'll see if they call a penalty on Braden Coburn. And one referee is pointing to him. Yes, there will be a penalty. Wasn't initially called, but eventually Walkham found him, and Coburn goes to the box.
Well, Wes McCauley was the referee that was down low. And then Stephen Walkham, I'm looking right over his shoulder, seeing the same thing he sees. Now you got all that activity around Boucher, and then up comes the net right here. Coburn dives. And when he dives, the Marsh peg comes loose, and next thing you know it, in the neutral zone comes Stephen Walkham with his arm up. Let's take a look and see if this is intentional. Now you can take it either way, but the bottom line is that net did come loose.
And so, more power play time for the Devils. Right off the face-off, Flyers clear it down the ice. Here's Mark, dropping it off. Elias, head fake, into the zone. Deals it down low, Thiemann in there. Betts over, Elias trying to get it back to the point. Betts had other ideas. And he'll backhand it the length of the ice. Already 30 seconds into the power play. Paul Martin leads the charge. winds it in. Richards rides it right to Gagne. Simone with plenty of time, won't rush. Takes as long as he can and then softly plays it down into the Devils zone. Some boos now from the Devils fans for their home team's power play.
Right, those aren't the Flyers fans going boosh.
That's right, not that time. 57 seconds, so already past the halfway point of this power play. Kovalchuk to get that to Zubas, broken up and clear, but not out by the Flyers. Turning with it is Green, shot into heavy traffic. It dribbles just wide, and then Betts able to clear. There have been three or four of those, by hitting something in front and just dribbling wide of that Philadelphia net. Make your own breaks. Green. This pass intercepted by Richards. Teaming will try to clear off of Green to center ice. A race for the puck, and Kovalchuk will get there in front of Gagne. And now Ilya Kovalchuk revving it up through center, falls down. It is really turning into a long night for Ilya Kovalchuk.
Yeah, anytime Ilya Kovalchuk wants to blow a tire, he can go ahead and do it if you're a Flyers defenseman backing up.
Set in by Motto. Power play now to its final 2 seconds. Flyers back to full strength. McCammon behind the net. Stripped by Carl. Another good defensive play, but then Hartnell coughed up the puck, and Niedermeyer will get it back to Motto. Motto flips one, blocked by who else? Matt Carl. And the Flyers get to it. Coburn looking behind him, back to Carl. And now Bartulis. Coburn fires with three defensemen out there as they still had Coburn on the ice after the penalty had ended. They'll get the lineup straight on the ice right now. 8:37 and counting here in the third period. Final score from Pittsburgh, upper right hand corner of your screen. Lower seeded Ottawa Senators with the victory. Flyers will try to make it a second Eastern Conference lower seed with a victory here tonight. But still a lot of work to do. Richards being worked over by Parise. Tosses him to the boards. Tiemann comes in. The puck bounces free to Langenbrunner. We get it back to the point, Salvador. Salvador wristing one, blocked off by Richards. Ooh, stabbed that by Carcilli. Had his stick up in the air there, almost hit a Devil. Now it's Martin Skula to it. Turns with it, Skula looking cross ice. Flyers get in the passing lanes. Heels it in along the wall. Parise back to Zajac. Zajac shot, save Boucher, rebound back. Salvador shot, blocked by Pronger. Bounces out of play. Squirted up over the glass and out of play. 7:49 to play in the third. Flyers by
7:49 remaining here in the third period of the Philadelphia Flyers leading the Devils 2-0. Let's take a look at our Wachovia. Great check of the game. Martin Skula right up against the wall, and watch Carter. Gets that shoulder right into him, pushes him. Skula kind of went down a little easy, but still, that's our Wachovia. Great check of the game.
Jeff Carter getting ready for this faceoff to the right of Brian Boucher. Carter still working himself into game shape, 100% game shape after missing 8 games with that broken bone in the foot. And that foot's probably not completely healed either, so he'll work himself into this series for sure as the Devils move that puck ahead to Clarkson. Cutting to the middle, Clarkson backhander off the outside of the post. Brett Boucher got a piece as well. Now it's Carter to the puck, finding Hartnell, but he could not hang on. Andy Green, Hartnell. Niedermeyer, Clarkson all in the battle for the puck. It's Breer who sneaks in to get to it. Carter checked by Martin at the red line. Minnesota products set things up for the Devils. Time becoming a factor now. It's now towards 7 minutes remaining in the third. Green ahead. Langenbrunner there to Kovalchuk. Kovalchuk has a look. His pass is to Skula. Back to Kovalchuk. And now it's Skula. Flubbing the one-timer, and it goes off his stick and out of play. This is the fourth playoff meeting between the Flyers and the Devils. They did meet once when the Devils were the Colorado Rockies. But since moving to New Jersey, those are your meetings. Never forget the 2000 Eastern Conference Finals. Flyers led that series 3-1. 95 Conference Finals, also a special series. As Claude Lemieux scored a big goal in that game that tipped the series the Devils' way. The Flyers victorious the last time they met, though, Coatsy, back in 04.
I think that Dougie Favell was the goalie for the Rockies at that time.
Oh, the first meeting, yeah. The Flyers have actually been successful in New Jersey. They've won 5 of 8 games all time in the playoffs in New Jersey. All those games at the old Continental Airlines Arena over at the Meadowlands. This is their first playoff game here at the Prudential Center. That's not bad, 5-3 against the Devils in their rink in the playoffs.
Not bad at all.
6:15 and counting. Skula. That pass off a stick. Coburn's back to get it for Philadelphia. It's away from Parise, but not Elias. Now back to retrieve, and a reverse to Coburn. Long for LaPerriere, off his stick to the red line, where Colin White will knock it down. Here's Zubras to Mike Motto. And now Zubras storming through the neutral zone, cuts to the right wing, fends off a check, barrels into Boucher, the puck is loose, and there'll be a penalty. Zubras got too much of Boucher on his way into the net, and he will go to the box. The Flyers to the power play when we return.
Chris Pronger is our subject of our Toyota Turning Point of tonight's game, and it's a great play. Now, we're going to take a look at Mike Richards. He's to the left in this play. He's going to get that puck right in front. Gagne's banging away at him. Look, there's Chris Pronger. From his point position, he comes in, takes the backhand, beats Broger to give the Flyers the 1-0 lead. Just seconds before that, he had been out at the blue line to make a great play to hold the puck in.
Elliott, Pronger, 3-4. Players in the playoffs right now. Season points. So the Flyers to the power play as Langenbrenner takes that shot. It's deflected and goes high and wide. Zubras, goal interference at 14:16. And the Flyers would love to get a third goal here, Bill. They also don't want to take any unnecessary risks.
They're dealing with a different animal. When you've got a 2-0 lead with 5 and change to go, you know that the penalty killers, you better have in your mind, every chance they get it, they're going to try and develop a scoring chance out of it. You got to play it with a 5-on-5 mentality if you're the power play team.
Puck deep into the Devil's zone. Colin White for Eliash. Tried to use the backhand to clear. Couldn't cleanly, although now it is nudged out to center by the veteran. Teaming in, gathers at the Philadelphia line. Ahead, Giroux for Richards. All the way across. The shot, Gagne off the post. Simone Gagne from just about the spot on the ice where he beat Brodeur to win a game in overtime in the regular season. That time he found iron. That puck ahead, knocked down by Carter. Simone Gagne has scored more regular season goals against Marty Brodeur than any player in NHL history. Jaromir Jagr second on the list, Eric Lindros is third. But Simone Gagne's on top looking down. He nearly had himself a postseason goal right there. 32 seconds on the power play. Carter, the beeline into the Devil's zone. And his shot, fought off by Brodeur. He got out to Carl. Carl set it off the side, and it bounced in front. Carter couldn't reach it. Eliash cut off by Hartnell, but then the puck bounced off Briere to center. Flyers get back to it. Power play down to its final 15 ticks. Boucher will set it up for Braden Coburn. Less than 4 minutes in the third period. Coburn, the right wing dish to Blair Betts. Betts is in. He'll just backhand it around behind the net. Brodeur is there. Couldn't get it past Betts. LaPerriere hustles over. Jams it through. Powell reaching for it. Now the Devils have it, and they're back to full strength. Zubas out of the box. Flings in. When he eludes Boucher behind the net. Artulis will try the other side of the ice. It got away from Zubas. Flyers will move it through center. Made by the Flyers, so there's no icing. They get a change, and here's Green moving up, chipping it in, knocked down by the high stick of Pronger, played by the Devils, no whistle. Niedermeyer centers! And McCammon may have gotten his stick on that puck, but Boucher was there anyhow, and he covers up.
Now the boos for Bouch. Brian Boucher's game is so different now than it was 3 weeks ago. Not only is his technique just about flawless, he's not leaky, that shot had no daylight to find. But his composure level is completely changed. Ramp so far up.
Richards and Zajac on this draw. The Flyers move it ahead, but not out of the zone. Richards will try, and off Hartnell. Gets out to neutral ice. Back to the Philadelphia zone. Zubris is the Devils will try to mount a charger. They need two to equalize. Running out of time. Bounces free here to Green. Back out shot. Zajac deflects, and they score! Parise was right in the way of Boucher. It bounces on in, and the Devils are on the board, and it's a one-goal hockey game, 2-1.
It's just a hard-working goal that we knew could happen for the Devils if Parise was allowed to establish his game down low. This is a Zach Parise play. Just a screenshot from the point. Travis Zajac had dropped back into a defensive position, and Parise was able to get his stick on it.
Well, you can see from that first angle that shot came from the point. Watch Parise. Nobody goes to Parise right there. Now he's got the opportunity right in front. Now, I don't know if he got a piece of that or not, but it certainly hit the pad of Boucher, but the screen enough was Parise going in front of Boucher that caused the problem. Could you guys see if Parise really did get a piece of that?
Hard to tell, Coatsy. A lot of different looks. Peter Laviolette has used his timeout.
Smart timeout call, too. The crowd finally has something to cheer about here. When you score a goal, you've always got a little bit of adrenaline to use. It's hard to tell from that angle. I know one thing. Zach Parise was the guy that took Brian Boucher's vision away on this shot.
You know what? He also got his stick.
Yeah.
Boucher's stick was pulled out of the way by Parise. By his skate there, Coach. Yeah. That's what allowed it to bounce by.
Right skate. He was just moving right in front and took the paddle right with him. So now the paddle's going one way, and Boucher's got to go down to the butterfly to be able to try to make that save. He gets screened. The paddle's gone the other way. That's a tough play.
Whether or not he gets the goal, Parise is the reason the goal took place. All right, 2-1, 2.5 to go here in the third. Buckle your seatbelts. Here's Richards to the Devils line. Richards finds some room and then tried to drop it back, and it's stolen. Zubris the other way, but Giroux poked it away from him. And then Claude to the puck tried to chop that into the Devils zone, but it went into the bench instead.
Play involving Mike Richards just a second ago, but he tried a drop pass, and it was a blind drop pass. Didn't turn out the way he wanted.
They're giving the goal to Travis Zajac.
Only Parise didn't touch it then.
Here's Elias. And now LaPerriere will clear it into the Devils zone. Less than 2 minutes to play. We'll keep an eye on Brodeur.
Keep an eye on Kovalchuk, too.
Elias turned that one over right to Pronger. Teaming it ahead for Richards. Richards will flutter that one into the Devils zone. Colin White turns and chases. Carter gives him a nudge. Richards after the puck. Right to center. It bounces off a body. Elias jumps on it. His long pass for Kovalchuk. And it was broken up by Coburn. You were right on that one, Bill. He was goal hanging. And that was inches away from a pass that would have sprung him. More frustration for Kovalchuk as Zajac fires in. There goes Brodeur to the bench. Extra attacker is now on for the Devils. Flyers get to the puck. Taking a look is Carl. Nice play there. Just chips it out in center. LaPerriere got to it. It hopped over his stick, though, and then Green the other way. Green dropping it off. In front of Zubris, a shot that goes wide. Bounces out the other side. Zajac got it as far as LaPerriere. And it's set along by Carl, but Betts trying to work it out of the zone. 52 seconds, and the Flyers do push the puck to the neutral zone. Kovalchuk looking to rev it up there. Kovalchuk in across the line. Run into by Carl. Carl took a seat, but he broke up the rush, and the Flyers clear the zone. And it's icing. Martin back for the touch-up. 40 seconds remaining in the third. Flyers just 14 shots, but they've made two of them count, putting them in position to try to protect this one-goal lead.
So much composure for the Flyers defensively, especially defending Ilya Kovalchuk. Yes,
He had some chances, especially one from the dead center of the slot. But the Flyers deserve a lot of credit for how they've defended him. For the most part, they've taken away his bread and butter zone, the neutral zone, so he can't get up that much speed. Now 40 seconds is all that separates the Flyers from a 1-0 lead in this best of 7 series.
Now as they talk things over, is this a chance to tell you about Sports Night highlights and analysis from this great game one, a review of the Sixers season, or a review, and a recap of the Phillies Nationals game. Get all the news Philly fans need to know on Toyota Sports Night tonight at 10:30 on Comcast Sportsnet. Jacques Lemaire, last second instructions for his troops. Odor will watch as 6 Devils skaters go to work against 5 Flyers plus goaltender Brian Boucher.
6 Devils forwards.
All forwards as Langenbrunner and Kovalchuk are out at the point. Zajac, Risa, Clarkson, and Eliash up front. The faceoff won by the Devils. Eliash a shot, it changed direction and went wide. Kovalchuk for Clarkson. Pronger, strong work along the wall. Richards in after it as well. Carter now battling. Worked it toward the middle. It bounces free. Powell couldn't get to it. Clarkson turnaround shot goes wide. Zajac backhands in front. It goes right on through. 22 seconds. A diving play by Powell. Couldn't get it out. Langenbrunner centered. Blocked off by Richards. Richards trying to clear. Kovalchuk is there to keep it in. To Clarkson for a shot. Loose puck. Elias backhander save. Boucher. And he covers up. One more big stop by Boucher. And it's still 2-1 and more frustration for the Devils.
Oh, the Flyers had a couple of chances to clear the puck and the Devils made great plays to seal off the boards. Finally, it comes to the doorstep of Brian Boucher. Patrick Eliash's backhand got under Chris Pronger and right to Boucher. If the Flyers can win a faceoff here, they will win this hockey game.
Back and forth it went before Boucher finally has to make this save. He did eventually make that save. And as a result, and they've added some time now, about 0.6 seconds to 10.2 remaining here in the third period clock. This draw to the right of Boucher. Carter against Zubras. Zubras won it. Eliash fan on the shot, and Richards able to poke it out to center ice. 5 seconds. Kovalchuk back on it as far as Richards. Kovalchuk fires again. Richards knocks it down. And the Philadelphia Flyers have taken game one of this series, breaking a 6-game losing streak in game one with a 2-1 final against the Devils at Prudential Center. And they take the lead in the series.
Well, there aren't many players that can't say they had a piece of this victory. The defense in front of Brian Boucher, especially against Zach Parise and most often against Ilya Kovalchuk, a great job. The forwards chipping in, capitalizing on a couple of plays. It's a complete effort. It had to be.
And the last line of defense was a very good one. On this night, Brian Boucher, our Bud Light player of the game.
Brian Boucher's poise just continues to grow, and his composure, his positioning now is completely sound. He's not overthinking anything, just reacting to what's in front of him. So living in the moment is what Brian Boucher has been able to do. And this moment right now, I'm sure, feels pretty good.
He's downstairs with Coatsy.
Well, is this familiar? Does this look familiar? I think we did this Sunday. I mean, this is becoming, I like this. How about you?
I'd rather talk to you now than talk to you a couple minutes after the game when it's not so good. So good start for us, a good win here. So we wanted the first one and we got it.
What's different about you? Describe, we're trying to figure out upstairs, and Billy Clement had some really nice things about how you're a different player right now. What do you think's different about Brian Boucher right now?
I don't know, Coach. See, I'm just trying to focus and do a good job, you know. That's all I can do. I mean, I didn't try to change anything, you know. I am who I am, and you know, like I said, I'm just trying to battle out there, and whatever happens, happens.
You know, this game is a strange game, and a lot of different things happen, and certain things happen that make things better. That shootout win against the New York Rangers, what did it do for you And what did it do for your teammates as far as your confidence level?
Oh, I felt good about myself after. I knew that I had a chance to make a difference, and that's what the shootout is. I mean, it's basically a chance for the goalie to win a game. And, you know, when our guys scored two goals, you know, it was a chance for me to shut the door happen. And I don't know, we've been playing playoff hockey for the last, you know, couple weeks. So this is nothing new to us. I mean, we had to play desperate, and we had to do that tonight. And we got the game won, and we're happy about that.
Boosh, congratulations. You're a Bud Light player of the game, and thanks very much.
Thanks, Coatsy.
Jimmy, back up to you.
Thanks, Coatsy. Brian Boucher, outstanding, 23 saves, and the Flyers take game one. Tonight's Flyers-Devils game was brought to you by your Quality Plus four dealers. By Bud Light, the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. By Wachovia, the official financial services partner of the Philadelphia Flyers. And by your local Tri-State Toyota dealers. Go Flyers, go Toyota. Toyota, moving forward. And so game one is history. And what a game it was. Lots of intensity. Expect more of the same when these teams reconvene for game two on Friday night here at Prudential Center in Newark. 7:30 or just thereafter puck drop. Our coverage beginning with the pregame show at 6:30. We'll completely break this one down as the Flyers and Devils get set. Flyers will be looking to take a 2-0 lead back to Philadelphia with them. They hustle and win. Flyers did plenty of that in this one. This stood a tough first period. The Devils got their chances. Then Chris Pronger scored. Mike Richards followed. And the Flyers were on their way. A 2-1 victory here at Prudential Center. Tickets for upcoming home games in these playoffs are available. Flyers postgame live is coming up next. For executive producer and director Brian Cooper and associate producer Chris Cajaro, as well as my partners Bill Clement and Steve Coates, I'm Jim Jackson. Good night from Prudential Center. Stay tuned now for Flyers postgame live presented by McDonald's.